What's up, guys? Welcome back to another Destiny 2 Wemp review video. I know I'm a little late on this one, but I do want to go over the Black Armory Pulse Rifle, the Blast Furnace, because I have some pretty solid rolls on them, and I think you guys will enjoy some of this gameplay. Now, how to obtain this weapon? First, you need the Pulse Rifle frame from 801. Complete the various steps to get the final frame and forge it at either the Izanami Forge, which you can do that, or you can forge at the Baguzi Forge for the chance at the Curator roll. So going over the perks I have on mine, this is my PvE one. Again, aggressive burst, hard hitting, 4-round burst fire. Next, we have the Mayron RDS and the Sactile Focus Lens sights. Definitely want the Mayron for that lightweight sight right there. You definitely want to be able to zoom in and out, have a good handling speed on this thing. Next, we have Drop Mag and Appendant Mag. Definitely went with Appendant Mag for the increase in magazine size, so I don't have to worry about putting on a backup mag. Drop Mag wouldn't be bad, but I don't want to waste ammo. Next, Feeding Frenzy. Kills this weapon, increase reload speed for a short time. That's why I don't have Drop Mag on, because I can just do that. Then we also have Rampage. Kills this weapon, temporarily grant increased damage. That stacks up to 3 times. Also, comes with a minor spec mod. Deals extra damage against Ring of Foul enemies. Then, comes with a Handling Masterwork. Now for PvP, I did end up getting a Feeding Frenzy kill clip version of this Pulse Rifle eventually, but at the time of the footage, I was using this one. Comes with aggressive frame, you know, hard hitting, 4-round burst fire. Next, we have 2 sights. One is actually a short zoom, one's a long zoom. Definitely went with that short zoom sight on this weapon. Comes with accurized rounds and drop mag. Definitely want to accurized rounds for that increase to range on this thing. Next, we have Zen Moment. Obviously, whenever you get hits with this weapon, it increases its stability. Then we have Slide Shot. So whenever you slide, it actually refills the magazine and it gives you a boost to range and stability for a short amount of time. Also comes with a counterbalance mod to keep that recoil direction up and down, and a ranged masterwork. And as you can tell, the range is almost maxed out on this thing, which is freaking insane. Going over the aggressive frame archetype, this is a 4-round burst pulse rifle, and since it's considered a 450 RPM archetype, it comes with what would be considered a small version of high caliber rounds. Any aggressive frame weapon actually has that intrinsically, if you didn't know that, but essentially it hits like a freaking truck. Mod wise, I would highly suggest a counterbalance mod for PvP and a minor spec mod for PvE, potentially even a rampage spec as well if you wanted to put that on. Going over a masterwork, I would recommend a stability or handling masterwork in general, but if you wanted to be a maniac, I suppose a range masterwork wouldn't be bad either, but again, this thing can hit at a distance, so I think a stability or handling masterwork will help out, kind of even out the stats a little bit. Going over PvE, this thing is so freaking good, it's insane. I love my God Roll Blast Furnace in any PvE activities, whether it's casual or endgame. I switch between using this and my God Roll Go Figure quite often. The aggressive frame pulses are easily the best to be using because they hit like a truck and you can shed through so many low tier adds because of the big mag size. Pulses have always performed well in PvE because of the bursting feature, allowing for consistency, and they can hit from a variety of ranges, which is more forgiving versus using things like hand cannon, which are good at short range, but if you miss, then you're out on some DPS. And I guess it's more forgiving than scout rifles as well, which are good at a distance, but they can be inconsistent because, again, the thing is you want to be able to hit headshots and keep up DPS. So a PvE gobble would have low to medium zoom sights, a pendant mag, tactical mag, extended mag, only when paired with either outlaw or feeding frenzy, steady rounds, or flared mag while in the magazine slot, outlaw or feeding frenzy in trade column number 1, and rampage in trade column number 2. Going over PvP, even in the crucible, this thing is crazy good. At the time I was using, again, the slide shot Zen Moment roll that I just showed you, but I ended up getting a feeding frenzy kill clip roll soon after. Since it is aggressive frame, it's probably one of the most used pulses right next to the bygones because of its consistency at a range, and it's pretty forgiving. So both of my rolls are really good to use in PvP, whether you want damage or stability. Pulses are really good in PvP because they're very versatile and forgiving if you miss a few shots versus other weapons. I don't know what else to say about this weapon because I really like using it, and the time to kill is pretty quick. It has one of the longest range stats out there on aggressive frame pulses in general, and it's crazy. I would rather use this thing over like a God Roll Go Figure or a God Roll Right Side of Wrong, to be honest. So again, this thing, like, you can tell from the clips, man, this thing literally shreds. It's insane. A PvP God Roll would have short to medium zoom sights, accurized rounds, tactical mag, steady rounds, or flared mag while in the mag slot, feeding frenzy, Zen Moment, or quick draw in trade column number 1, and kill clip, rampage, or slide shot in trade column number 2. Going over Gambit, this is where it can shine on both PvE and PvP sides. We already know this thing slaps in PvE at any range, so it can be up in the fight collecting moats or staying back shutting down enemies so your team can bank bigger blockers and allows you to eliminate blockers and keep your bank open. Even on the PvP side, it would be good because it can hit from a distance, which means If you're out of heavy and special ammo, this weapon can come in handy when taking out the enemy team. I've definitely had a few situations where I ran out of ammo and this thing just kicked in and just took them down. So I will say, if you're using only this weapon, you will be outgunned by certain weapons. But in a 1v1 situation with another primary weapon, like, you can definitely win that fight. And, like, the weapon's just very versatile in Gambit since it can perform well on both sides. Going over some useful exotics and perks, I can't think of any relevant exotics to use, but any pulse rifle perks will help you out a lot. Going over my final thoughts, overall, this is easily one of the best current pulses to use in both PvE and PvP. It can keep up with weapons like Go Figure in PvE and Bygones in PvP, and can serve a lot of purposes when it comes to Gambit. We're now at the end of the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, but there are three things I want to go over. First up, my clan, the D1 Fireteam, is looking for active players in the Destiny community. Our members play all sorts of activities from casual PvE and PvP to the end game content. If you're actively playing Destiny 2 and want the benefits of a bigger clan, the link to join is below. It'll say clan link. All you have to do is request a join and myself or one of the admins will approve you. If you're with a smaller clan and want the benefits of a bigger clan and you have, like, let's say, like 7 to 10 members, I'm just using that as an example, but if you want to come over, just send me a message on any of my social media links and we'll try to get something set up. Number two, if you want to know how to support me, there's a link below that says best way to support me. That'll take you to a 4-minute video form. Go check that out. That would be awesome. But if you don't want to do that, you can always like this video, subscribe to the channel, share this video, and all that good jazz if you want to do any of those things. Lastly, we have a link to the community Discord below. Just a heads up, we're looking for anyone with moderator experience to potentially run the Discord. I know for myself, I'm more of a player instead of a manager. So if you have some moderator experience, just send me a message and we'll try to get something set up. I know for myself, I'm on Xbox, but if you guys would like to talk or chat with me, Discord is going to be the best way to do those things. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. We'll catch you next time.